Know Your Heritage, the quiz show series that features competing high school students testing their knowledge on African-American culture, both past and present. And now, the host of Know Your Heritage, star of stage, screen, and television, Jack Cookwood.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And welcome to the 10th season of Know Your Heritage. Now, as you know, for the past 2 weeks, we have been pleased in that we have been able to highlight the African-American experience. Now, in our quarterfinal games, if you've been playing along, you know that this is our big semifinal show. So we started out with 8 teams representing 32 Chicago area high schools. Those teams competed in our quarterfinals. And the winners were the Airs, the Prodigies, the Trailblazers, and the Explorers. Now, these teams will be competing in our semifinal games today, with the winners going on to compete in our championship game next week. So let's get to it, shall we? Let's meet our 8 players today. Let's start with 4 of the players to my left who comprise the team of the Prodigies. Welcome them to our show, please. And they are captained by Yusan. Introduce yourself.
Welcome. Hi, my name is Yusan Charles, and I attend Hales Franciscan High School.
Okay.
Hello, my name is Veronica Watson, and I'm a junior at Dr. Martin Luther King Junior High School.
Welcome back, Veronica.
My name is Katrina Turner, and I attend High Park Career Academy.
Okay.
My name is Emma Johnson, and I attend Dunbar Vocational High School.
The Prodigies, ladies and gentlemen. And to my right, the Airs. Welcome them to our show, please. And their team is captained by Tiffany. Tiffany, introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is Tiffany Hurd, and I attend Resin Oil Community Academy.
Hello, my name is Robert Robeson, and I attend John Marshall Metropolitan High School.
Hi, my name is Johnny Williams, and I attend Austin Community Academy High School.
Hi, my name is Delsandra Marks, and I attend Jones Metropolitan High School.
And they are the Airs. Okay, now we have met our players, and they are ready to play the game, and we are ready to start our first semifinal match. But first, a brief word from our sponsors, so why don't you stay with us.
Know Your Heritage is brought to you by the McDonald's owners of Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana. People's Gas, we're putting our energy into Chicago. Coca-Cola Classic, you can't beat the feeling. Amoco, take your driving to the ultimate. And Sears, proud to encourage the youth of our community and proud to sponsor the Chicago Public High School Academic Olympics.
Okay, we're back. Now, before we get started, let me take a moment and explain how our game is played. Now, teams can build points in 3 rounds of competition. In rounds 1 through 3, teams will answer questions from 9 categories. The team that buzzes in first will have a first shot at the question. Now, if they cannot answer, a member of the opposing team will attempt to answer the question. Now, in round 2, the speed round, each team will have 30 seconds to choose 10 correct answers. All right. Now, we've explained the rules, we've explained the game, so let's play the game. Is everyone ready?
Yeah.
Great. Now, remember that you will have 3 seconds to answer each question, and the first round will take 90 seconds to expire. So good luck to everybody. Let's get to it, shall we? The category is sports for 10 points, and the question is, in 1982, Ernie Banks' baseball jersey was retired.
14.
Yusan, what is the number of his jersey? 14. Well done. Okay, so then performing arts for 10, the question is, Mahalia Jackson was known for what type of voice?
Contralto.
Katrina. Ask Yusan, but I think you're right. Contralto is correct. Performing arts for 20, Chicago's Jazz Entertainment Center during the 1920s was located in an area known by what name? Katrina.
Black Belt.
That's the one. Landmarks and population for 10, what address marks the DuSable site? Tiffany?
401 North Pioneer Court.
Well done. For 20, what Chicago school is named for Isabella Baumfrey? Tiffany.
Sojourner True.
You got it. Business for 10. Chicago has how many black-owned banks? Veronica.
4.
That's correct. For 20. Liberty Life Insurance Company became what existing?
Spring Life Insurance.
Yeah. That's the one company. Creative Arts for 10. Ernest R. Rather was the director and publisher of what book? Tiffany.
The Negro Yearbook.
I need a complete answer.
Negro Almanac.
Judges? No, I'm sorry, that's not the correct answer. The correct title was The Chicago Negro Almanac and Reference Book. Close, but we've got to have the correct wording on that. So, that's the end of our first round. Let's see what the scores are. At the end of the first round, the Prodigies have 70 points, and the Heirs have 30 points. Give them all some encouragement, ladies and gentlemen. How are we doing so far? Okay, great. Now, we're going to ask you at home to stay tuned, because coming up is our second round. That is our speed round. You won't want to miss it. Stay right there. Second round, our speed round. Now, in our speed round, each team will have 30 seconds to choose 10 correct answers from a list of 20 possible responses. Now, the correct answers will be worth 10 points each. Now that our team captains are in position, they will place a marker beside the 10 answers which their team selects. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, you've got 30 seconds with which to answer in this speed round. Good luck to all. The question is, identify 10 Chicago schools named for prominent African-American Chicago residents. Start the time now. 25 seconds. 20 seconds. One-third of the time is gone already. Coming up to one-half of that time. 15 seconds left. Come on, kids. You can do it. All right. 10 seconds. Whoa, look at this. Someone's burning rubber. Okay. We're coming into that last final 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Time is up. Please step from the buzzer. Okay. Well done. Well done. I love it. The Heirs went crazy because Tiffany was sitting down 2 days ago. Ladies and gentlemen, well done. Okay, good luck to you, and good luck to you, too. How do you think you guys did? Okay, let's see how everyone did. For our audience playing at home, let me now tell you what the correct answers were. Okay, they were Lorraine Hansberry, Oneida Cockrell, Elaine Goodlow, Neil Simon, Edward Beasley, Midian Boosfield, Mahalia Jackson, Wendell Green, Wendell Smith, and Irvin Mollison. Okay, good luck to both teams. So, let's find out where we stand with reference to those scores. The Prodigies got 7 correct out of 10, giving them 70 points, bringing their current total to 140 points. Prodigies! Okay, and the Heirs got 60 points. They've got 6 correct out of 10, bringing their total to 90 points. The Heirs. Terrific, terrific. Okay, so now that we have completed our first 2 rounds of play, and we know what our scores are going to be, let's take a look and see just exactly what sort of prizes our 2 teams here are playing for. Floyd?
Jeff? Each of our schools will receive this special Know Your Heritage plaque, and players will receive this pin of academic excellence. Trophies are awarded to each member of our first, second, third, and fourth place winning teams. Plus, later in the game, we'll tell you how our teams can win a free trip to Disney World and scholarships to the college of their choice.
Thank you, Floyd. Thank you very much. Those prizes are terrific. Now, let's start our final round. Now, remember, this is the last round. After this round, we will have a semifinalist going into the final round. I wish everyone the best of luck. There's only 50 points separating these 2 teams. A great, great match. Good luck to all. The category is civil rights for 30 points. This is the question. Who was the executive secretary and the only staff member of the Urban League in 1933? Emma?
A.L. Foster.
Correct. Well done. For 40... In what year did Mayor Joseph Medill commission a black 9-man, Emma?
1872.
Fire company. Well done. Religion for 30. Today, the revitalization of the Nation of Islam is being led by whom? Yusan.
Louis Farrakhan.
That's the one. Well done. For 40. The Reverend Herbert Martin served as director of what city commission? D'Alessandra? 3 seconds. Time's up. Prodigies, Veronica?
PHA.
That's not correct. It was the Commission on Human Relations. Okay, this is a visual, so please watch the monitor. Politics for 30. How many black aldermen currently serve in the city council? Veronica?
18.
That's the one. Well done. For 40. What district does Chicago Senator Richard Newhouse represent? Veronica?
4.
You're on a roll. Professions for 30. Sam Greenlee served as co-producer and co-writer of which movie? Emma?
The Spook Who Sat by the Door.
Hello. Okay, for 40. Darthula Young, a former city employee and wife of State Representative Anthony Young, is vice president of what firm? Johnny.
Datacom.
Complete answer, please.
Lockheed Datacom.
That's the one. Well done. Sports for 30. How many touchdowns did Gale Sayre score in the 1965, Robert?
6.
That's not correct. Prodigies?
22.
You've got a buzz in, but that was correct. 22, you signed. Okay, another visual. Sports for 40. What was Fergie Jenkins' career record of wins with the Chicago Cubs? Robert?
It was 284.
You got it in at the buzzer. 284 is correct. So, let's see where we are now at the end of this rounds of play. The Prodigies have 370 points. The Airs have 170 points. Congratulations, we have a new champion. They are the Prodigies with 370 points. Well done, well done. And they will be back next week in our championship game. I'd like to thank both of these fine, fine teams for participating in our game. And I'd like to invite you to stay with us because right after this break, we're going to have another exciting semifinal game of Know Your Heritage. Please stay with us.
Know Your Heritage is being brought to you by the Illinois State Lottery. Have a ball, play the lottery. And Luster Products, makers of PCJ Relaxers, Pink Oil Moisturizer, Hair Lotion, Oil Sheen, and Holding Sprays.
We're back! And we're back with game two, our second semifinal round with two brand new teams. Let's meet them, shall we? We've got the Trailblazers and the Explorers. But first, please welcome the Trailblazers. The captain of that team, as you remember, is Valerie. Reintroduce yourself, Valerie.
I'm Valerie Fullwood, and I attend Morgan Park, and I'm a senior.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Reginald Barnes, and I'm a senior at Christian Finger High School.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Zoe Squire, and I'm a junior at Percy L. Julian High School.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Rhonda Figures, and I'm a senior at College High School.
And they are the Trailblazers. Yes, they are. Let's also welcome, though, their opponents, the other team, the Explorers. And they are captained by Ashanti. Welcome them, please. Ashanti, introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Ashanti Jones. I attend Lincoln Park High School.
Welcome.
Hi, I'm Andrea Short, and I attend Harlan Community Academy, where I'm a senior.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Tanya Brock. I attend Harper Career Development High School.
I'm Malcolm Weems, and I attend Lane Tech High School, and I'm a junior.
The Explorers, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, now you know the teams and you know the rules. Teams, remember that you have 90 seconds for rounds 1 and 3, and you've got 3 seconds to answer each question. So let's begin. Good luck to both semifinalists. Congratulations for getting this far, and good luck in your attempts to continue. The first question is in the category of sports for 10 points. And the question is, who became the president of the Negro American Baseball League? Valerie?
Andrew Rule Foster.
That's incorrect. Let me finish the question in 1939. Explorers, you've got an opportunity to respond. Andrea?
Dr. J.B. Martin.
That's correct. Dr. J.B. Martin is correct. Okay, for 20, the question, who is the first African-American sailor currently preparing to... Valerie?
William Bell Pinckney.
Now, that one you got. Well done. Currently preparing to circle the world. Performing arts for 10. What well-known female choreographer was influenced by Haitian dances? Malcolm.
Debbie Allen.
That's incorrect. Trailblazers? Time is up. Catherine Dunham. Okay, for 20. Who became the first African-American pianist to debut at Orchestra Hall? Reginald?
Dorothy Dunnigan.
You got it right. Well done. Landmarks of population for 10. The question, along with many others, poet laureate Gwendolyn Brooks refers to Chicago by what other name? Malcolm.
Brunsville.
That's the one. For 20, which school holds claim to being the first predominantly black school in Chicago? Zoe.
Wendell Phillips.
That's the one. The buzzer didn't go off, but everything else did. Well done. Okay, this is an audiovisual, so please watch the board. Okay, business for 10. Name, Andrea?
John Johnson.
No, the question was, name the autobiography of John H. Johnson.
I'm succeeding against the odds.
That's well done. Well done. Okay, for 20. In 1922, what ice cream company was founded by seven, Valerie?
Baldwin Ice Cream.
That's incorrect. Time was up. The question was, 1922, what ice cream company was founded by seven postal employees? The answer was the Seven Links Company. So, let's see where we stand now at the end of our first round. The Trailblazers have 70 points. The Explorers have 20 points. They both deserve rounds of applause. But now, before we move on into our critical second round, our speed round, let's find out what prizes our semifinalists will, or rather our finalists, will win. Floyd, tell us about it, please.
Our first-place teams win an all-expense-paid trip to Disney World in Orlando, Florida, courtesy of Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Chicago. And that's not all. Each player on our second-place team receives a $250 scholarship. And each member of our championship team receives a $500 scholarship to the college of their choice.
A college scholarship. Well, now that is worth its weight in gold, and that's outstanding, and it's appropriate because it goes to our gold medal finalists, okay? So now we've completed our first round, and we move on then to our speed round, our second round. Okay, now the teams can add as much as 100 points to their score in this round. The team captains are in position, and you know the rules. You will have 30 seconds to select 10 correct answers, and that is our, and that, of course, is in our speed round. So let's press on to our speed round question. Good luck to all eight of you. The question is, identify 10 Chicago published literary writers. Start the clock. Good luck. 25 seconds. Okay, we're one-third of the way down to 20 seconds now. We're halfway there at 15 seconds. We're coming along that back stretch, ladies and gentlemen. We've got 10 seconds, and we're into that final countdown now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, time is up. Please step away from the board. Step away from the board. Valerie was sneaking that last one in there, trying to get that in. I saw you trying to play it off, let me tell you. Okay, so that was a good round. That was a good round. Good luck to everybody, okay? So, for our audience at home, let's find out what those correct answers were, shall we? They were Fenton Johnson, George Washington Ellis, Margaret Burroughs, Wallace Terry, Haki Madhubuti, Alfred Duckett, Frank London Brown, Roy Ottley, and finally, Hoyt Fuller. Okay. Good luck to everybody. Have the judges completed their tally? Yes, they have. All right. The Trailblazers got 5 correct out of 10, or 50 points, bringing their total score to 120 points. Congratulations. And the Explorers also got 5 correct for 50 points, bringing their current total to 70 points. Congratulations to the Explorers. Okay, now we press on to our third round. Remember that our third round is our final round, the round that will determine which of our two semifinalists will move on into the final round. There is 50 points separating our two final teams, so good luck to both of them. Let's begin that third round, shall we? Now remember that the answers are worth 30 and 40 points in this round. Let's begin. Our first question is in the category of civil rights for 30 points. The question is, who authored the Civil Rights Bill of 1885? Valerie. 3 seconds.
John Jones.
Sorry?
John Jones.
No, that's not correct. Explorers, an opportunity to respond. Okay, time is up. That was... There we go. Time is up. John W. E. Thomas. Okay, for 40. In what year did the Chicago City Council pass the Black School Law? Valerie.
1863.
Well done. 1863. Religion, for 30, which church is aggressively rehabilitating the Inglewood community? Rhonda.
Antioch Missionary Baptist.
Well done. For 40, in what year was Isabel Joseph Johnson's show first aired on television? 3 seconds to both teams. Rhonda.
1967.
That's incorrect. Explorers.
1967.
Someone buzz in.
19...
Go ahead, Malcolm.
1968.
I'm sorry, that's not correct. It was 1964. Politics for 30. Who did Timothy Evans succeed as alderman of the 4th Ward? Malcolm. 3 seconds. Trailblazers. Okay, time is up. Claude W.B. Holman, politics for 40. Prior to his election to the state senate, how many terms did Adelbert H. Roberts, Reginald?
3.
Well done. Serve in the House for 40 points. Professions for 30. Rosemary Gulley, formerly of WSTV, Channel 7, is director of what Chicago operation?
Chicago Rhonda. Transit Authority.
Well done. For 40. This dynamic black woman attorney serves as legal advisor. Malcolm?
Bethune, Mary Bethune.
I'm sorry, that's not correct. I'll complete it for the Trailblazers. Ah, time is up. But the question was, this dynamic black woman attorney serves as legal advisor for the Illinois State Board of Education. Name her Bernetta Bush. That ends our third round. The Trailblazers have 260 points. The Explorers have 70 points. We have a new semifinalist. It is the Trailblazers with 260 points. Congratulations to them. That was our semifinal game. Now, of course, we're going to be back next week where we will have our two semifinalists battling it out in the championship final round. Stay with us, please. We'll be right back to present our awards after this brief commercial message. Welcome back. Now I'd like to introduce two of our corporate sponsors, Mr. Sam Harmon of the Black McDonald's Operators Association and Ms. Karen Goddard of Luster Products to present the awards to our winning teams. Sam?
On behalf of McDonald's, I am pleased to present the trophy to the coaches and players of the third place winners of the Airs. I would like to congratulate these teams on a fantastic and wonderful job that they did. Congratulations.
And on behalf of Luster Products, I am pleased to present these trophies to the coaches and players of our winning semifinalist team, the Explorers.
Thank you, and congratulations. Congratulations to all. Audience, we've had a good time, haven't we? Okay, great. Congratulations to everyone. Now, we have met some outstanding students today, and we've played some great games. But now there's more to come. I'd like to personally invite you to tune in next week for our championship final. But until then, I'm Jeff Coopwood, and I want to urge you to know your heritage. Take care. Bye-bye.
Know Your Heritage has been brought to you by the McDonald's owners of Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana. People's Gas. We're putting our energy into Chicago. Coca-Cola Classic. You can't beat the feeling. Amoco. Take your driving to the ultimate. And Sears. Committed to the development of our community's future leaders and proud sponsors of the Chicago Public High School Academic Olympics.